Hi, it's Bruce with the Part-Time Prospector, and today I want to show you a little technique that I use to find long-lost gold mines and old workings in WA using freely available aerial imagery that you can access using GeoView WA or even Google Maps. This is not a technique that you can use offline, like in the bush with no signal. You have to use it with a signal and you part of your research. So just jump straight in and I'll show you how to do it. First thing you do, and I'm going to use GeoView, let's crank up GeoView. It's the easiest one of the whole lot to use because I can show you the old workings in relation to the aerial photography. It's much harder to do that in Google Maps. So let's jump straight into GeoView, type GeoView in the search engines, up pops this page, hit the big red button, and it may ask you to log in, and you will get once you've got past that, you get a page that looks like this. You'll see a whole bunch of available layers down the side, and that is basically what you can use to turn on and turn off. A lot of this is going to be noise, so I'd suggest clicking on all available layers, choosing geology, and zooming down and turning off everything except dimmers base map. Now, for this example, I want to show you what the vectors to look for to help you narrow down what are the countryside. You don't just want to be panning across the countryside aimlessly. So a quick recap of how gold is formed, and it's super quick. I'm going to keep it just a few seconds. Mineralization sites, and we will go gold. It's loading. Okay, you can see a lot of gold deposits, known gold deposits. Well, I'll rephrase that, mapped known gold deposits. There's a lot of gold deposits out there that don't show up on any geological maps. So let's zoom in on the area. And I'm actually going to make sure I turn off the dimmers base map. So there is the distribution of gold. So if we go to the geology section, and I'll just crunch that up and go to geology, where's geology gone to? And I'll turn that on. We don't want field observations and we don't want the base maps. But what we do want is the 1 to 500,000 linear structures. Turn that on, oops. Okay, these are the known and mapped faults across WA. These do not show a single fault plane. They are a representative line of a zone of shearing and faulting. So the gold can occur on that line or parallel to that line for potentially hundreds of meters either side. So this is what we're going to look for. So as you zoom down a bit, and I toggle this layer on and off, you can see there's a very close correlation between structures and gold mineralization. Okay, so I'm just gonna go turn this off and turn this back on so I know where I am. And I'm gonna turn this mineralization site off. So I'm gonna just show you a place just north of Southern Cross, and I'm only using this as a demonstration. Please, some of these locations I show you, they may fall on live leases, guys. They may fall on live leases. You know the rules. Do not go on live leases unless you have written permission from the leaseholder. Do not go on them. Stay on the pending, stay everywhere else. Do not go on the live leases. I'm not going to show which is pending or live. It's up to you to figure out, because this information changes on a day-by-day basis. Okay, so as I zoom in, oops. I need to turn on my 500,000 linear structures again. And one of the things that caught my eye was from Southern Cross, heading up towards the northwest, we've got what looks like two or three sub-parallel structures coming together just the other side of the Salt Lake. And there's a twisted area of intersections of faults and an interesting looking location. Places where faults intersect or bend or change direction are where gold is likely to precipitate out. Okay, so this is obviously a zone here and a zone here further up the thing. So let's just zoom in on this point here. I just like the shape of this nice bendy fault. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna turn off the dimmers base map and turn on Landsat aerial imagery. This takes a little few minutes to load. Remember, this is a government website. Things don't load fast. Okay, so we're zoomed in, and I'm just going to show you that there's the structures here coming down, Here's the underlying aerial imagery, and you can see there's something sitting in here. This looks like a different type of country out here. Now you may say, oh yes, but this brown stuff is alluvial sediments, and almost certainly it is. But what that alluvial sediment possibly represents is that where a fault cuts through the rocks, it makes the rocks more brittle, it makes them more susceptible to erosion, and they form channels, and those channels can fill up with water or become zones for rivers and low points. And so this actual bend in the dark bit here, representing the bend here, is most probably where the fault is. May not exactly be where the line is, but it's most probably where this fault is. So first thing, I'm going to jump in here and turn on the mineralized sites again. Maybe I should have left them on last time, but I didn't. Okay, mineralized sites, and we'll turn on. So according to this GeoView, there is no gold mineralization in this image. Okay, nothing could be further from the truth. So I'm going to look down along the structure and see what we find. I'm zooming in, let the imagery catch up. We can see the zone that comes through the brown bit. I'm looking here for signs of old workings, and I'll show you what old workings look like in a second. But what I want reason to show you this is at the bend in this fault structure, we have this striated area, for want of a better word. And to my eyes, that looks like a rehabilitated dry blowing site. And it's quite large in extent. You can see the scale bar down the bottom here. And this is been an obviously an operation that's been there for a while. There's even a farm down dam down the bottom, or maybe farm dam, but a dam that may have been used for the processing. And so they've tried to rehabilitate the ground again. So this is a sign that there was quite extensive gold mineralization just at this location, but it doesn't show up on any geological maps. So keep an eye open for these striated areas in aerial imagery, because they're good signs of pushing or of rehabilitated pushing and dry blowing areas. The other area I want to show you, and guys, I want to keep this a super quick video because some of my videos do go a bit long, is if we go around the corner and I zoom down to this location here, and I'm actually going to look along the edge of this brown and lighter color, and straight away something catches my eye. Now this whole act or practice or routine you go through to try and find old workings is a lot to start with training your eye, and you have to know what you're looking for. So straight away on this aerial image, I can see at least one line of old workings. And so I'll actually just go to the drawing thing and I will turn on freehand. And out here, I don't know if you can see these white specks that are running through the image. That is almost certainly a set of old workings. Now I'll turn this one to here so I can pan around without deleting my imagery. There's something happening there, but I wouldn't be too confident what that is. And I'll zoom along and keep looking. There's something out here. Sometimes it takes a bit more. You need to just zoom out a bit. And we'll look along. There's not much more too exciting happening here. But as I'll go to a spot that I know. So we've got that marked on the map. And there is a spot up much further north where these structures intersect. And there's a whole bunch happening here. Now there's a yellow dot here representing mineralization. Okay. But if we zoom in further, and I'm mostly using this so you guys can see what old workings look like in an aerial image. And you can see there, oops, where's my drawing tool? There is a sign of old workings right there. And I'll just move the map a bit. And back to the drawing. There's another set down here. There's another set by the looks of it over here. There's another set running through here, possibly running down here. And there's possibly a set over here, and there's some out here, and it looks like there's maybe something running along there. So just in this little area, we've picked up, what's that, 6, 7, maybe 8 lines of old workings. We head north. Is there any continuation? Come on, imagery, you can catch up. And we've got another set running out here, and we've got possibly something coming through there, but this definitely looks like an extension. to that set of workings identified earlier. So guys, this is a quite a powerful technique. Spend some time looking at where the structures occur on the map. Look for bends, intersections, and flexes in the imagery. And you can see we've picked up quite a good zone of map of workings, quite possibly extending down into here. And so these are ideal locations for you to mark on the map, record the GPS, drop them into your app, and the next time you're out bush looking for locations, don't forget about these. These are ideal locations. So next time you go looking around, just remember what these things look like. You may not have the yellow dot to guide you, but you can see the similar sort of structures that are cutting through the landscape, and that is the old workings. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next video.